You're watching We Love DevOps, a video series on testing and DevOps brought to you by Team Miracle.
Hello everyone, I'm Monica Kodakuti, Lead DevOps at Miracle Software Systems. Today, I'm going to show you a small demo on building CICD pipeline onto Microsoft Azure using Visual Studio Team Services. For that, let me first quickly walk you through our today's agenda. First, we will be discussing what exactly VSTS is, the services provided by VSTS, today's delivery pipeline architecture, and then we will be quickly jumping onto a live demo. So what exactly is VSTS? VSTS includes software development, collaboration, measurement, and reporting tools that work broadly into a server-side and as well as client-side applications. So basically with Visual Studio Team Services, it is very fast and easy for you to plan, build, and ship a software across a variety of platforms. Also, we can create any number of private team projects accessible from anywhere using Team Foundation version control service. Also, as you can see on my dashboard, it supports different services like source control, build management, release management service, work item tracking, by using which it will deploy an application onto the infrastructure. So let us discuss deeply about all these services. So the first one, source and version control. This will help us to create multiple versions of code which can be accessed in parallel along with the capability to store snapshots of a code. So basically that is named as labels. And we can create different branches and commit the code similar to other version control softwares like Git and Bitbucket as well. So the next service is build management. This will basically fetch the code from the source and version control service, and it will compile them together, which is also capable of performing quality checks as well. This supports different templates like Ant, Maven, etc. So you can select on depending on your project. The next service is release management service. So this will automate the multi-stage deployments either serially or parallelly. So basically, we can do deployments onto only Azure services or Azure VM directly. The next service is work item tracking. So it will basically support the management of requirements, efforts, tests, bugs, etc. And it also facilitates teams to become very agile. Moving on, so this is the delivery pipeline architecture, and this is what we are going to implement in our today's demo. So if you can see on my screen, I have configured my local machine as an agent where I have my required Maven and Java installed. I'm pulling my code, building and deploying it using build management service onto my Azure VM. Also, I'm running my Selenium test cases for validating my application's login page. So without any delay, let us quickly jump onto the live demo in order that so you'll understand better of what I'm speaking exactly. So this is how my VSTS dashboard looks like. If you want to create a project, you can go ahead and click on a new project and give a name and select on create. I already have my project created, so let me just quickly open that for you and show it. So I have a project named CICD_Azure where I have imported my code as well. So you have different flexibility options where you can import your code directly from your local machine, or you can also import it from your Git repository as well. So right now, you can see all the options over here provided by VSTS, the code, build and releases, test, etc. So I'm just clicking on code in order to show you the code which I have uploaded. So this is the code which I'm having right now. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to configure my agent. For that, I'll just go into the settings tab and click on agent queues. So once when you get onto the agent queues landing page, you'll find an option of download an agent. So basically what we are going to do is we are going to download an agent. It will basically give us a zip code which we are going to download it onto the machine which we want to make it as an agent in order to communicate our local machine with VSTS. So in my case, I'm going to make my local machine as an agent. You can also go ahead and make a VM, example an Azure VM also as an agent where you have all your prerequisites installed. So on my machine, I have Maven installed because I'm going to run my Maven job. So if we click on download, it will ask for options like Windows, Linux. So you can go ahead and choose one. So mine is Windows, so I'll go ahead and click on download. I have already downloaded and unzipped for you. So So let me just go ahead and show it to you. So if you can see, this is how we'll get once when we unzip. So you have run.cmd and config.cmd. You need to first run your config.cmd, which will ask you to configure the credentials of your VSTS environment in order to make your machine communicate with our VSTS dashboard. I have already configured that, and those credentials can be found on your VSTS dashboard directly. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run. I'm going to open my command prompt, give run.cmd. So it will take just a couple of minutes in order for the agent to come up and running. Yes, so now if you can see, my agent is listening for jobs. Let me just get back to my VSTS dashboard and check if my agent is running. So if you can see, we were having both in an offline state. And right now my machine, guest 369, has come into the online state. So you can integrate any number of agents with your particular VSTS dashboard, and you can select on which agent you want to run as well. So right now I'm selecting on guest 369. So I have configured my local machine agent to the default queue. And so that we are successful now on configuring this one, what I'll do is I'll go ahead and click on build and releases, where I'll be able to configure my job. So in build and releases, if you click on builds, you'll get an option to select your required template. Since I've already told you that I'm going to use a Maven project, I'll go ahead, click on new definition. Yes, so here I'm going to go ahead and give Maven and click on apply. So it will now ask for all your configurations. The agent which we have configured also, we will be selecting over here in our job now. So once if we scroll it down, we have default private one. I'll select that. Also, since the VSTS will create a local workspace in our agent, we need to give our pom.xml path in order for VSTS to understand where exactly our pom.xml is so that it can run that particular job. So I'm going to copy and paste my path over here. Yes. Yeah. So that everything is configured. Now what I'll do is I'll go ahead and click on save and queue. Click on save and queue once again. So it will ask if you want to select a branch. Right now I'm having my entire code in the master branch, so I'm not going to change it anymore. Just scroll down and click on save and queue. So if you can see, my build got queued. This is my build number. So if you click on this, it will automatically redirect you to the build. So VSTS also shows us the console output where you can see each and every step getting built. As you can see, so it will take around 5 to 6 minutes for the entire process to get completed. So basically what is happening is I have converted my entire code into my Maven project, and I'm giving my pom.xml a path. So this is going to take up my code, pull it basically from my source and version control service. It is going to build it, and it is going to deploy it onto my created Azure VM. So now if you can see, my build got succeeded, and let us see whether the application got deployed or not. This is my Microsoft Azure dashboard, and this is the VM onto which we are going to deploy my application now. So I'm just giving the public IP address of this particular application. We can see a sample application getting deployed onto this. Also, if you can see, the Chrome browser got initiated in order to show the test reports. And if you can see, all my test cases got passed with a result pass. And now what I'm going to do is, we have manually triggered the build for a job. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to automate it. For that, just go back to the dashboard. In the builds and releases, you'll find an option triggers, where it will be assigned to disabled. What I'm going to do is I'm just going ahead and clicking on enable. Click on save and queue. Or else you can just click on save. I'm just going to save it because I'm not going to queue any build right now. Also, as we are running the test cases for login authentication, let us quickly change the password object and see if the test cases fail. For that, I'm getting back into my code and click on edit to modify it. And I'm changing from password to password one, my object. go ahead and click on commit and give commit. So once the code is committed, it should automatically trigger a build job. So let us go back and check in our builds. And so if you can see, it is in progress. So that means a new job got triggered automatically when we have committed the code. Since I have modified the object, let us see if this code fails the deployment and gives us the failed test cases. Yes, so if you can see, my test cases got failed, that too in step 3, that password is failed. So this is how we are going to build a CI/CD pipeline onto Microsoft Azure using Visual Studio Team Services and also run your Selenium test cases for your application as required.
Thank you for watching our video series brought to you by Team Miracle. For more videos on testing and DevOps, please visit miraclesoft.com/welovedevops.